Press where your brand envelope is too much. Even Fanny Kayode, who has never mobilized anybody in Nigeria, was projected to be a leader, courtesy of press, not because he has any constituency, not because he had anybody around him, not because he had people that are behind me like this. But Fanny Kayode has always been promoted every day, courtesy of brand envelope. The day he shocked all of you, you have all now left him, and nothing about Fanny Kayode. So it is all about the press. The press are the ones that are disturbing Nigeria because of brand envelope. And enough must be enough of that. Give adequate report, merit people that merit whatever. Tinubu has no problem with Nigeria. He has done and paid his due. So, and we must stand by that gentleman arrangement. PDP too are falling in the same situation where they are confused about power rotation. So why will APC say they are confused at the same time? Has it been a problem? The day Tinubu is having an agreement with Buhari, are you telling me we are so stupid not to know that Tinubu, who put people in body law and put them inside bus and go and vote in the primary against Atiku with $10,000 does not have an agreement with Buhari, then you must be joking. So I want to beg anybody, any distractor, that the youth of nowadays are not willing to allow this. And that's why we have committed ourselves. We started mobilizing from the southwest, northwest, north central. We only have few states to do. We have done 19 states out of 36 states of federation, so that we can drum support for Asiwaju, and Asiwaju winning this election will not be a surprise to anybody like it did during MKO Abiola. Because I know quite all right, there are people evil against any learned Nigeria who want to rule Nigeria. And these evil are people that have been benefiting from Nigeria resources since 1960 and which are colonial masters. They have not started their game. But when it is time for Tinubu to come out, they will work against him and go and bring a stupid person who will end up in wasting the South time. Tinubu will develop both North and South. Everybody knows that. There's no doubt about that. In 8 years, he has a commissioner which is an Hausa man and Igbo. So we knew he has all the pedigree to rule Nigeria. But people are against it. Why? Those people have been using a stupid person to rule Nigeria so that they can be stealing our resources. And we must stop that. And the youth must stop now. And we must tell the colonial master, the France, to stop on Nigeria issue and move away to their country. We are not going to be distracted any longer. And that's why we are drumming support for Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu. It is his time. Everybody know. And the good thing about it, I will have a problem in Southwest if any member in PDP is coming out for president. Obasanjo technically killed all PDP for Tinubu to rise. Because when Obasanjo was technically killing all leaders in PDP, Tinubu is carrying the same block to build the empire and APC. The empire is there now. We are all living in it. We say Tinubu should leave that house. Does it make sense? Does it make sense? Today, when they are saying youth could come to power, people who have benefited, because politics is all about patronage, who have benefited as a minister, supposed to come out in Yoruba land, to come and save us and present themselves as a leader. But is it Fanny Kayode who was favored? Is it even Fayose who was favored? So where are the leaders that in youth, a lot of youth that are taking gum? So we will not allow distraction. Tinubu will put us to the next level. And we must allow him to do the work for the peace of Nigeria. And I want to let you know, the power that is enshrined in power rotation is all about solving Nigeria problem, which is even all these things that is bewildering us in Northeast. Power rotation is enough to solve the problem. And I will give you an analysis. When Obasanjo was in president, there was a group called OPC. They were taunting other regions in Nigeria. Obasanjo was so tired for 8 years that you have to even get Gani Adam arrested. But immediately Obasanjo left office, what happened to OPC? They become a gateman and security officer, and they fizzle out. And the next thing we hear, because it's Yar'Adua that came into power, is Boko Haram. Immediately Yar'Adua died, what do you hear? You hear Niger Delta. All the appeals to Niger Delta, both amnesty and what have you, didn't solve Nigeria problem until Jonathan lost power. And the power go to Buhari. You don't hear about Niger Delta. So now you are hearing Badi Tree, you are hearing Boko Haram, you are hearing Togri and all of you. And people are politicizing it. It is in Nigerian culture for people to criminalize presidency. So immediately the power rotates to the south now. Nothing you will hear again. It's not about military. It's not about God. Because any military dispatched to the earth, they too want to benefit. Even if there is a peace, because there is no money, they will say, oh yeah, bomb something. Let's have it. We know that. So the solution to Nigeria's problem is power rotation. And we must prepare Nigeria for a man with full experience who will not allow clannish people to rear their head again, which is Bola Ahmed Tinubu. And that is why I'm so resolute about it. And I must shout it loud for Nigeria that for the peace, tranquility of Nigeria in 2023, we have no other thing. It is non-negotiable.